while fashion isn't necessarily important in the grand scheme of the world necessarily, it can be really important to an individual. So I like to make earrings that make, I guess when I wear them, like that make me feel really confident. I guess all that is to say, I make stuff that I want people to feel confident in.
Hi, my name is Amy George. I'm here interviewing with Boringham TV, and I am the creator of Amy Makes Jewelry. Graduated from University of Montebello in 2015, which is an uncomfortably long time ago, and I got a degree in painting and drawing with a minor in game design. So segueing into clay was kind of an unexpected thing for me. I was really little. I had this teeny little Sculpey set that was just basically all these different color blocks of clay. And I didn't know anything about them, so I would just make like snowmen and snakes and stuff that doesn't really require any sort of degree of knowing what you're doing. So that was fun, even though it kind of all cracked in the oven and it was terrible, I still really enjoyed it. Fashion is interesting for me because if you are dressed the way that you want to be dressed, or if you're wearing what you want to be wearing, or even if you have some really cool earrings on, it can make you more able to, I guess, function as the person that you want to be. Like, everything I make is something that I would want to wear myself personally. So typically when I'm making something, it's because like I've put on something and I'm like, wow, this could really look so much cooler if I wore an earring that looked like this, or I wore a pin that looked like this. I'll just go make it. So all of the clay is polymer clay. It's a type of clay that essentially plasticizes at a really low temperature, typically around like 270 to 275 degrees. So that's the main material that I use for everything. And tools-wise, typically it's an X-Acto knife. Everything is usually cut by hand. It's pretty common in the polymer clay community to use cutters. I don't typically do that. I have like a tiny little circle cutter and like a tiny flower cutter, and I'll use this sometimes for like earring bases. Other than that, it's usually just using my hands to shape things, or sometimes I'll use eye pins for dotting, and then other like various assorted little metal things. A lot of my materials I do have to source from online because I use titanium for all of my earring backs, which you can't get in local craft stores. And the reason why I do that is because it's one of the best metals I've been able to find for sensitive ears. And I want everybody to be able to wear these. I don't want it to necessarily be limited to people who don't have metal allergies. So titanium has been the best thing for that. Huge polymer clay community in Australia, which is super random. But it's actually been a really wonderful resource because so many of those people are also wonderful teachers and like their techniques and their materials and all that. And there isn't anybody in Australia that's doing anything like what I'm doing, but those people have been such wonderful sources of inspiration for me. There is Heidi Hellyard has been a big inspiration for me. She is the person who I looked at to try to figure out how to do this, because I did start from zero. I didn't know how to do this before, obviously. So Heidi was really wonderful because she is a teacher. On her Instagram on how to do this and her website and stuff, so she was a really wonderful source of inspiration for me. It definitely makes me a happier person. Painting and drawing is wonderful, but it's also very stressful because it is so planned and because it does take so much time. They will take days, hours, months, years sometimes, so doing this is a lot more freeform. And it's just really satisfying to be able to go into something with a perfect image in your head, come out with that perfect image that you dreamed of, and then be able to wear it within, you know, not a month or a year, you know? So it's more immediately gratifying in that way, maybe a little bit more immediate sense of happiness, so.
It depends on the earring. If it is something that is just like a solid cutout, it's definitely a lot different in terms of time from doing patterning. Patterning can take hours. It kind of depends on how complex I want to make it. I don't plan out any of it in advance, so it's just me thinking of it as I'm doing it, and you can't go backwards. So if you've made a decision, you have to stick with it for the entirety of the earring. So that is to say, the process itself takes several days because you have to make the clay perfect first. If you're me, you have to make the clay perfect. And sometimes that will take an hour in and of itself, just rolling it, picking out anything that's in it, rolling, making sure it's perfect. The longest that I've ever been in the studio is definitely up to a full day. Mostly just because of my own tendencies. I'm the kind of person who, when she starts working, doesn't really want to stop, and that's just kind of me. And I don't like not doing anything. I'm a full-time job while I'm doing this, so I definitely don't have all day to work. It's extremely limited to nights, it's limited to weekends, it's limited to days off. So that's led to some pretty interesting challenges, because even though the sun is down and it's winter, you still have to glue, or you still have to drill these earrings, and you still have to like turn out this finished product for, you know, whether for you or for somebody who's ordering. Well, because it's earrings, earrings have typically been seen as more of a woman's thing. So typically women who are around my age or older or younger, I think the age range for this kind of a thing is super broad, because it's just shapes. And everybody can get into shapes. So it's not necessarily limited by an age per se. I do also cater to some guys. Some guys are super into this and I love it. I think, again, because it is shapes and it can be any color, it really just depends on the personality of the person who's wearing it as to who it is catering towards specifically. I haven't been doing any sales through websites necessarily. I've been doing it through Instagram, which basically, like, you know, message me, I can make you something, I can do customs for you, that kind of a thing. But what I really want is to have somewhere where people can go and actually choose from a selection. So whether that is, you know, getting Etsy up and then eventually doing a website of my own, or doing Etsy and sticking with it, or just the website, whatever. I have to work that out. I feel like it would be the easiest way for people to be able to access what I'm doing right now. But in terms of places where you could go to find my jewelry physically, like right now, I have work at Basic, which is on Morris Avenue in downtown Birmingham, or you could also go to Wheelhouse Salon. The one in Homewood and the one in downtown both have my jewelry right now. And then of course you can message me, and my Instagram is just Amy Makes Jewelry, so it's pretty easy to find me.